Thanks to our friends at The Motley Fool for sponsoring this video. Check out the link below, fool.com/thesmattering, to get access to the 10 best stocks to buy right now. Hey, everybody. SoFi Technologies just reported earnings. The stock has been taking a beating, but the business looks absolutely fantastic right now. I'm Jason Hall. This is The Smattering. Jeff Santoro is here with me. Hey, Jeff.
Hey, how you doing? I'm glad we're talking about SoFi. This is a company I've been interested in for a while, but don't own yet. So I'm excited to dive in. Before we do, I just want to ask all of our viewers to please subscribe to our channel. If they like what we're doing, that helps other people find the channel, and it helps us spread the word. And also, we have a podcast called The Smattering that you can find on any podcast app. So we'd appreciate it if you check that out too. So Jason, SoFi, like I said, been looking at it for a while. I really haven't wrapped my head fully around the business. Tell me why this quarter was so strong.
So I think the business is a little bit misunderstood. So SoFi historically has been a personal lender, a personal loans, and before that even really, really doing a lot of student lending. If we think about what's happened during the pandemic up through now with deferments of student debt and now student loan forgiveness, there's a tremendous amount of headwinds for that business. But the reality is that SoFi has continued to grow and diversify its business away from just this student lending that was really a big part of its past. So this is from its third quarter presentation. You look at this number here, this members growth, right? So this is people that have joined SoFi and use one or more of its financial products, whether it's a loan or whether it's one of their financial services products like their bank accounts and that sort of thing. You see the level of growth here. Last quarter, grew members year over year 61%, continues to grow at an incredibly high rate. We carry that over and look at the products that are used, 69% growth there. I think this is really important because I'm going to go back because you look at these numbers here for member growth, 87, 70, 69, 61. The products growth is consistently higher. What that means is that members tend to add products, financial products, from the SoFi offering over time. And that's a sign of a really healthy business that people like. Jeff?
Do you have any concern that the year-over-year growth rates are decelerating a little bit, or do you think that they can stay really strong for a long time?
So I'm certainly not concerned about it, again, because the bottom line is that it's growing those numbers at such an incredibly high rate. And the reality is, at some point, they are going to come down. But I would say if you think about their total number of members, right, it's 4.7 million. There's over 325 million people in the United States. There's a tremendous amount of opportunity to continue to add more people to its financial services products, particularly younger financial services products consumers who gravitate towards the online offerings that SoFi has, right? So yes, those numbers are going to decelerate over time, but I think it's still going to be growing at an incredibly high rate going forward. So again, you look at, this is one that I think is really, really important because you see it is still growing its lending products at about 24%. That's actually accelerating, right? So coming out of the pandemic years, that's accelerating. I think that's really healthy. And again, it continues to grow its other financial services products at an incredibly high rate as well. You look at the net revenue number, you know, in this 51% year-over-year growth, that's not as high as these addition, you know, these member additions and product addition numbers. But again, you think about the rate of growth, it's consistently been at a very high rate. Realistically, even if that slowed to 25-30% in the next year or two or three, that's still a pretty high rate of growth for essentially a bank, right? This is now a bank. They have a banking charter. They are the bank of record anymore. By making that move, they're in a much stronger position to be able to compete with the Bank of America's and the Wells Fargo's and the big banks out there because they don't have to pay a bank in the middle that's going to get the lion's share of the profit from things like deposit accounts and that sort of thing. This is an important one, adjusted EBITDA, and it's always important to be really careful with adjusted metrics, but this is earnings before interest, tax, depreciation, and amortization. This is a metric that for most of the past few years has been an EBITDA loss, And now they have shifted this into a pretty strongly positive number. And I think that's a really healthy thing. And this I like a lot, Jeff. Think about everything that's going on with the economy, thinking about the pressures, rising interest rates, inflation, all of those things. SoFi just said, we're going to raise our guidance for the rest of the year. We're going to increase our adjusted EBITDA by $10 or $12 million. We're going to increase our net revenue by a small amount. This is positive, right? This is really positive that it says they continue to cultivate that those relationships with banking customers, and they continue to make headway. Now, I think the reality is that for such a high quality business, it's gotten to a point where it's almost too cheap to ignore. It's trading for a discount to book value. You look at any high quality bank that's stable, generates enough cash flow, and that trades for a discount to its book value, that's a bargain. That's absolutely a bargain. Tangible book value about 1.7 times, again, is very reasonable. And here's the thing. Is this a perfect business? No, it is still investing a tremendous amount of money. Managing the balance sheet is hyper important. But if you really start looking at closely at the balance sheet, the assets they added when they acquired their bank versus the liabilities they added, the books balance out pretty well. It's a pretty stable business. I think it's too good to ignore right now, Jeff.